Voice search is rapidly becoming the preferred method for users to seek information, make purchases, and interact with their devices. According to Google, 20% of the searches in the Google app are done by voice. And that was back in 2016. And fast forward today, 30% of internet users worldwide use voice assistants each week. Around 98 million people in the US own a smart speaker in their household, and the list goes on. Even my kids, 8 and 6, search for things with their voice. It's much easier for them. And with this rising trend, shouldn't we optimize our content so that it can be found with voice searches? It makes sense, right? So in this video, we will talk about ways to optimize your content for voice searches. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one WordPress plugin that brings you the fastest and the most convenient SEO and AI tools. And this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. Anyway, let's talk about how you should optimize your content for voice search. Optimizing your content for voice search requires a different approach compared to traditional SEO. Voice searches tend to be longer and more conversational, which is why focusing on long-tail keywords and natural language is crucial. For example, instead of typing weather Paris, we might ask, what is the weather like in Paris today? Voice searches often follow natural language patterns and includes question words like who, what, where, when, why, and how. For example, who invented the telephone? Why is the sky blue? These are the typical questions my sons will ask when speaking with Google. What are the health benefits of green tea? Where is the nearest coffee shop? When is the next full moon? How do I make pancakes at home? So by understanding that users are asking complete questions, you can structure your content to provide comprehensive answers. Let me share with you a couple of free tools to help you discover conversational keywords. First is to use your Google Search Console to discover existing keywords people are searching for to discover your site. Under the Performance tab, you want to select Queries and add a query filter. And then you want to select custom Regex. Regex is the short form of regular expressions. It is a little technical, but don't worry, just follow me. So to discover keywords with question words like who, what, where, etc., you want to place this set of Regex operations in the field. Don't worry about typing it out. I'll share with you where in a while you can copy this. Now, as you hit apply, it will display all keywords that contain those question words. Click on each of the query and find out which page it belongs to, and you can optimize from there. Alternatively, you can start with a page and discover the queries for the page, and you can use the same set of regex operators to filter out those queries with question words. There are other regex operators that are helpful as well. For example, this set of operators will help you find keywords that are longer than 30 characters. This other set of operators will help you find keywords that are longer than 3 words. And if you want a full tutorial on how to use Google Search Console to its maximum potential, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Now, for keywords that your site may not be ranking for, you can use a tool like Answer Socrates. Just type in any topic, for example, home improvement, select a country, give it a while, and it will generate a huge list of questions that people typically ask. And some or most keywords resemble voice search keywords. Another way to identify conversational keywords is by simply Googling. For example, when I Google camping kit, as you scroll down to the people also ask section, you will see conversational queries. As you expand one, you will see a couple more questions coming out that are related to the one you have expanded. Keep doing that and you have lots of voice search keywords ready for you to be optimized. So the key to identifying voice search keywords is to prioritize natural conversational phrases that people are likely to say out loud. Now, in case you don't know what a feature snippet is, for some search queries, there are immediate answers right at the top. Some people call it position zero, but the proper term for this is the featured snippet. Now, studies found that featured snippets comprise about 40% of voice search results, and it also delivers answers to 80% of Google Home users. So it is only logical to optimize your content for featured snippets, but how should you do it? The key is to have 4 elements in the introduction of your article. A direct answer in a conversational tone, give concrete examples, and in concise sentences. For example, if you are working on a topic, how much should you save for retirement? What you want to do is to add a response that is direct, concise, and conversational, answering this query in a way that could be easily spoken by a voice assistant. Like to determine how much you should save for retirement, aim to save at least 15% of your annual income. If you start saving in your 20s or 30s, you might need to save less each month compared to starting in your 40s or 50s. For example, if you earn $50,000 a year, saving 15% means putting away $7,500 annually. Adjust this amount based on your retirement age and lifestyle goals. Now, I'm not a personal finance expert, but can you see that we are answering the question directly to the point in a concise and conversational manner? And we have also included a solid example. Or if you are writing on a topic like what is the best app for tracking expenses, you could optimize your intro for featured snippets like the best app for tracking expenses is app A. I can't specify an app right here in this demonstration, but you get the idea. Anyway, App A is free and easy to use, allowing you to link all your bank accounts, credit cards, and bills. It automatically categorizes your spending, helps you set budgets, and send alerts for unusual expenses. For example, if you spend more on groceries than usual, App A will notify you. This makes it simple to track where your money is going and manage your finances effectively. Can you spot the four elements in this paragraph? So for every article you write, you should try to optimize your introduction for featured snippets so that voice assistants can pick up the information and feature them in their reply to users. Anyway, let's talk about the next optimization. Just like English is a human language, Schema is like the language of the search engines. It helps search engines understand the contents on your page better, which is crucial for voice search. And do you know, if you are a Rank Math Pro user, we have a Schema markup specifically designed for voice search called Speakable Schema. This schema is designed to identify sections of your contents suitable for text-to-speech playback. So to implement the Speakable Schema, you need to have both the free and pro version of Rank Math installed. Now, the Speakable Schema is embedded in the article schema, so we recommend that you set the article schema for all your post articles. To do that, hover over Rank Math SEO, under Titles and Meta, go to Posts, and for the schema type, you want to make sure that the article schema is selected, so that when you visit any of your articles, go to the Rank Math tab, and under the schema options, you will see that the article schema is applied to the page. Now, if you click on this edit button to check out what's in the article schema, you will see this option to enable speakable. By default, it is set as disabled. You want to enable it, and you will see the CSS selectors. What you want to do is to click on add property twice, and then in the first field, you want to add .headline. Now, in general, this depends on the WordPress theme you use and the class assigned to your H1 heading tag. For example, if you go to this page, right-click to view its page source, you want to hit Ctrl or Command F to find something on a page, then you want to find /H1. With it, you will find the title of the page. And can you see that at the start of the H1 tag, there is a CSS class assigned to it called Heading Large. This is the headline CSS class you want to select for the speakable schema for the particular page. So in that case, you want to add .heading-large as the CSS selector. But in our case, the CSS class will be headline, so that the speakable schema will be added to your H1 heading tag. And then for the second property, you want to add .summary. And this will tell the search engines that the paragraph with this summary class will have a speakable schema on it. Now, you need to define which paragraph in your article to apply the speakable schema, because by default, nothing is defined. So it is logical that whatever paragraph you have optimized for the featured snippet, the speakable schema should be added to it. And for our case, it is the first paragraph of the article. So you want to click on anywhere in this block, then click on this options button and edit the block as HTML. Now, by default, all paragraphs will have this P tag. This is the HTML language that tells the search engines or robot that this block of text is a paragraph on its own. And I know for some of you who don't know any CSS coding, it might seem confusing, but don't worry, just follow me. At the start of the paragraph, right beside the P, you want to hit space and define this block with class equals start of the double quote. Remember, the class we are selecting is summary, so we will add summary here, and you want to close the quotes. And that's it. And if you are seeing an error like this, what you want to do is to convert this whole block into HTML, and that would solve the problem. And with this, the speakable schema will be applied to this paragraph. If you want to double check if this is the correct application, let's publish this page, go to the page, Right-click, view page source, Control or Command A to select everything, and Control or Command C to copy. Or you can just right-click and copy as well. Then go to the Google's Reach Results Testing tool. This is the link. We have left the same link in the description. You want to select the code option and paste the codes here and run the test. Then under the detected article schema, you want to click to expand it. I haven't added an image, so don't worry about that. Anyway, under the speakable schema, you will see that the value of the dot summary CSS selector is the block of text we have selected. And that means that the speakable schema is properly applied. So by implementing the speakable schema, you are increasing the chances of your content being read aloud by voice assistants like Google Assistant, Siri, or Alexa. If you are getting value from this video, we will appreciate it if you help us out by smashing the thumbs up. Anyway, to the next optimization. As we know, voice search queries are more conversational and question-based compared to traditional text searches. And when you align your contents with the way people naturally ask questions, it makes it easier for voice assistants to retrieve these answers. And hence, having an FAQ section with the FAQ schema on every rankable article makes perfect sense. And to do that, though there are a couple of ways to add an FAQ schema with RankMath, but we recommend this. At either the top or bottom of the page, you want to click on Add Block, Browse All, and you want to search for FAQ, and here's the block you want to add. Alternatively, the shortcut would be to hit slash FAQ, and you will find the same block. As you click on it, you can add your FAQ questions and answers. The FAQ schema will be added to whatever that is within this FAQ block. Now, the topic for this page is how to properly clean BBQ gas grill. So one of the questions could be, are you supposed to clean the inside of a gas grill? You could write your answer here, but for me, I would ask Content AI to write it for me. It saves me a lot of time. By the way, if you don't know, you have 750 free credits every month as a free RankMath user. If you want to learn more about it, you can check out this video that is popping up at the top right. But anyway, if you want to add another question, you can simply click on this button. And now you can add another question here. For example, do you clean gas BBQ grill after every use? It is intuitive to use the FAQ block. But just do not hide all questions. It does not make any sense and you will get schema errors. You need to make sure that you have at least one FAQ question and answer visible. By embedding FAQs in your content and leveraging the schema markup, you are enhancing your content's relevance for voice searches. Mobile optimization plays a crucial role in voice search optimization, mainly because the majority of voice searches happen on the go, with a mobile device. Hence, ensuring that your website is mobile friendly, quick to load, easy to navigate, and visually appealing on smaller screens is essential. To check if any of your pages are mobile friendly, you can leverage Bing's mobile friendliness test tool. Just pop any page's URL here and click Analyze, and in a few seconds, you will know if your page is mobile friendly. If a page is not mobile friendly, you will see results like this. Now, having a mobile friendly website is not enough, especially for voice searches. Answer needs to be delivered fast, so your page loading speed needs to align with the expectations of voice assistants. And the best way to know if your page is loading fast enough is by testing your pages with Google PageSpeed Insights. This is the link. We have left it in the description as well. Simply place your page URL here and test it. With the mobile version, you will get all the page speed information, which includes all the things you need to optimize. A score above 90 is ideal. If you want to learn more about how to optimize your page speed with practical examples, we recommend that you check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Now, this is for you if you have a local business. Imagine I'm too tired from a whole day's worth of shopping. I'm too lazy to type, so I'll ask, "Hey Siri, what is the best Italian restaurant near me?" I'm not interested in Italian restaurants across the country. I want a restaurant that is near me and which is good. Chances are when Siri replies, I'll probably visit that restaurant. So optimizing your business for local SEO is super important, and it starts with claiming and optimizing your Google Business Profile listing. This is essentially your online storefront, so make sure that your business information is accurate and up to date, including your address, phone number, and hours of operation. And don't stop there. Get your business listed on other online directories relevant to your industry, like Yelp, TripAdvisor, Squarespace, space, etc. The more places your business appears, the more likely it is recognized by search engines for local voice searches. If you need a step-by-step guide on how to optimize your local business for SEO, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. So there you have it. These are the key strategies to optimize your content for voice search. If you have any questions or anything to add, feel free to leave a comment down below. And don't forget to smash that thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to us, do so, because we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.